Do you ever have the problem that you totally want to read a book, probably a nonfiction book, you pick it up, you do actually read it, and you know it was super interesting, but you can really only remember a fact or two from it, and when your friends ask or when you want to talk about it at a party, you think, oh God, it was so interesting and I love it, but you just can't retrieve that information from your brain? Well, I have this problem. So today's tip, and by the way, everybody, I'm Gretchen Wegner. I'm the creator of the anti-boring approach to powerful studying, but I also have tips good for grown-ups. And today I want to talk to you about a book that I'm about to read. Looks really good, right? Rest. Why you get more done when you work less. And I'm wanting to read it for myself, but I'm also wanting to read it for my clients because I feel like we push our teenagers way too hard. And they do rest. They force themselves to rest, but not necessarily in ways that are very rejuvenating to their brains. And I do the same thing, right? I'm so busy during the school year, and then I am burnt out at the end of the school year, and I'm not even a teacher anymore. I stopped teaching so that I could escape this burnout cycle, and it's not working. And so I'm starting to believe that it's really something in the institution of education that is the problem, and not necessarily simply finding the right habits. However, I do think we can all still work to find the right habits, and I'm hoping this book will help me. However, I've already read 2 chapters, and I can't tell you anything about those chapters other than super interesting. I said, I underlined a few things, but I just don't remember the details anymore. So I am committed to using you all to help me be accountable, and I have created a wonderful note-taking format that I want to share with you right now. You're looking at it. It's called a book chart. And I teach part of this process in my online course, The Anti-Boring Approach to Powerful Studying, but I'm going to share some of it with you on YouTube because it is so valuable. So what you see in front of you is actually the outline of the book. So I opened it up to the table of contents, and I figured out how many chapters there are, and these are all the chapters right here. And I'm especially excited to read that one right there about sabbaticals, because I think it might be time for me to take a sabbatical. But I laid all this down, and then I noticed what the sections are. So there's an introduction that has 2 chapters. Part one has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 chapters, and part two has 4 chapters in it. And then there's a conclusion. Now you'll notice that I left, this is a spreadsheet, right? But I left this blank cell underneath part one. And that is because, here, I want to move us over just a little bit, and I want you to see how I figured, how I'm organizing this. So I'm going to go back and read, or probably more likely skim, chapter one, The Problem of Rest. And if there are any interesting facts that I want to capture, I'm going to type them and their page number here into this cell. And then I'm going to make myself write a phrase or a sentence that sums up the main idea from this chapter in this spot. I'm going to do the same thing for the chapter, Science of Rest. And then, because I'm at the end of the section, I'm going to actually force myself to write a main idea statement for what this section is telling us. And it's got to be my main idea, hopefully, not anything from the author, so that I'm forcing myself to use my noggin right there. And then once I've done that, I'm going to do the same project for part one, or process, I mean, for part one, and then part two. And then when I'm, and for the conclusion. And then when I'm done with the whole book, I'm going to write the main idea for the whole book right there. Now, I suspect that the main idea for the conclusion right here is going to be the same as for the book, but I don't know. So it already helps me to give myself a map for where this book is going. And I did not give myself the gift of giving myself a map when I read these first 2 chapters. So already I can tell I'm going to get more from the chapters because I have the bigger picture already. I'm going to do some of this work and then create another video to show it to you, and this will keep me accountable. I want to do this in a few weeks. I want to read this book. So stay tuned, And if you have any questions about this process, I am always available at gretchen@gretchenwegner.com. And if you want this and many other rockin' study tips to help you have your best semester ever, whether you're in high school, college, or grad school, you can check out my Anti-Boring Approach to Powerful Studying online course, which is available at my website, gretchenwegner.com. Take care, y'all. Bye-bye.